We're here today on Gritolo, New York, and we have Marissa Otero with us today. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
Great. In fact, sitting next to you, I'm getting a little tan here. You have a lot of bling on you.
Yeah, well, you know, you have to wear the bling.
you're very pretty.
Thank you.
And I know that we're going to hear you sing soon, and I know that you have a very lovely voice. What's it like to be so pretty and be able to sing so well and be in front of an audience?
I feel their excitement, and it gives me like this crazy adrenaline rush, like a roller coaster. So.
A lot of people get stage fright before a big show.
I want to go on the stage and I just want to stay there.
That's great. When did this begin? When did you know you wanted to become a star?
I was 9 years old and I was watching television. I grew up in Puerto Rico, and my mother had Gloria Estefan's homecoming concert on, and I was watching. I was like, wow. I brought my mother into the living room and I said, that's what I want to do for the rest of my life.
And you knew right away you had a good voice, or did you have to sing first and go, oh, I do have a great voice?
It was something that came through time. I think I had to develop my voice a little bit, and I did take private vocal lessons and piano lessons, and I was classically trained in college, so.
I try to sing solo. So low, no one hears me. But you have a voice, and where are you performing nowadays?
This summer has been pretty busy for me. I've gone to Dominican Republic, Puerto Rico, Florida, upstate New York. Today I'm with you, having fun, and I will be performing in Disney as part of their huge choir for a Christmas show. But I do have some stuff coming up in New York City soon.
And what's your ultimate goal? Where would you like to perform the most? If someone said you could perform anywhere you wanted, where would it be?
I want to sell out Madison Square Garden.
Madison Square Garden. Well, if you can make it there, you can make it anywhere.
Yes, there's no doubt in my mind. If I sold that out, then I've reached what I really want in life. And it's not the money. It's more like I love singing in front of massive amounts of people.
You know, what makes you feel that you're going to make it over the thousands of other people that are trying to become stars?
I think it's about believing in yourself. It's a little bit about faith. And if you leave any room if you leave possibilities for failure, I think you'll fail. But if that's not an option,
failure is not an option.
Failure
for you.
Is not an option. It shouldn't even be in your head. Oh, what if? No, what if?
I
nothing?
Think you can make it to the moon.
The moon
you
is mine.
You could certainly make it to Madison Square Garden. So you're going to sing for us which songs today?
My first Everything. I wrote that a long time ago. I released it in 2006, thinking about my first boyfriend from when I was a teenager. Uh-huh. And then the second song is Not Lost Anymore, which was after a horrible breakup, trying to get over this other guy. I woke up one day, I was like, no, that's it.
Boyfriend's breakup. I think after today, you're going to have many more admirers than you did yet before this show. So I can't wait to hear you sing. Look forward to it.
Cool.
Let's go hear you sing.
Okay.